Hi friends, welcome to NS School Education YouTube channel. Today I am going to teach you grade 10 mathematics lesson, and that's unit 7, factors of quadratic expressions. Now let's start the lesson. You all know that 2x is an algebraic term. We call it as an algebraic term because there's an algebraic symbol here, x. So this is an algebraic term. When we take 2x plus 10, this is called a binomial algebraic expression. Why do we call this as a binomial algebraic expression? Here, the word bi means two. As there are two terms in this algebraic expression, we call it as a binomial algebraic expression. Coefficient. So, what is the coefficient? Coefficient means the number in front of the algebraic term. Here, the algebraic term is 2x and the number in front of x is 2. So, here the coefficient of x is 2. When we factorize 2x plus 10, we can get 2x plus 5. So the factors of 2x plus 10 algebraic expression are 2 and x plus 5. These are the factors of 2x plus 10. So this is a binomial algebraic expression. Now let us see what's trinomial quadratic expression. What's the meaning of tri? Tri means three. So in trinomial quadratic expression, there are three terms and one of it is a square number. That's why we called it as a quadratic expression. We are writing the quadratic expressions in the form of a squared plus bx plus c. Here a, b and c are numbers, so we can substitute any number to these symbols. If we take n squared minus 4n minus 21. Then the fact this is a trinomial quadratic expression because there are three terms. Now let's see how to factorize this trinomial quadratic expression. N squared minus 4n minus 21. So in order to factorize this, it should have four terms. So to take four terms, there's a method. The number in front of n squared is 1. So we are not writing it as 1. 1 into 21, it's 21. So we should find factors of 21. We can take 3 into 7. So here 3 and 7 are factors of 21. So we have to find how can we make 21 from 3 and 7. Yeah, how we can make minus 4, sorry, how we can minus 4 from 3 and 7. We should make minus 4 by 3 and 7. So, we can make 7 positive and 3 negative. 7 minus 3, we get the answer as 4. So, then we can rearrange this expression as n squared plus 7n minus 3n minus 21. We should write n for the two terms because we are finding it for minus 4. Then we should add minus n to these two terms and we can simplify it. First, we should find the common factor of n squared and 7n. So the common factor here is n, right? So we are taking n outside, n plus 7. And here the common number for both these two terms are 3. So we are taking 3 outside, and as it is minus 3, we should write here also minus 3. Minus 3n plus 7. Positive into negative, negative. So we should write the symbols correctly. Then take the common factor and write it as a one bracket. And next we should write these two numbers also. So this is how we factorize a trinomial quadratic expression. Now let us discuss exercise 7. In 7.1, we are going to discuss second part. A and first one. X squared plus 6x plus 8. First of all, we have to find the factors of 8. We can take 1 times 8, 2 times 4. Those are the factors of 8. So we should select the suitable pair of factors to make the number 6. 2 and 4 is suitable to make 6. So in order to make 6, we should make both these two positive. And we can rearrange this expression as x squared plus 2x plus 4x plus 8. And take the common factor outside, it's x. X plus 2 and common factor of term expression is plus 4 x plus 2. Write the common factor in one bracket x plus 2 and the remaining one in one bracket x plus 4. This is how we factorize. And next, let's discuss, this is A, next discuss C. So, here, factors of 12. We can take 1 into 12, 2 into 6, 3 into 4. Those are the factors of 12, and we should select the most suitable factor out of these to make 8. This is, we can make 8 using 2 into 6. both should be plus. And let's rearrange the expression. P squared plus 2p plus 6p plus 12. Here it's p, so we should write p for these two also. Common factor is p, take p out, outside. P plus 2, common factor is 6, p plus 2. Take the common bracket, p plus 2, and the remaining into one bracket, p plus 6. Now we will discuss question E. M squared plus 11m plus 24. Here we should find the factors of 24. We can write 1 times 24, 2 times 12, 3 times 8, 4 times 6. So those are the factors of 24. And we should find the most suitable one to make 11m. Most suitable one is 3 into 8. We can make 11. So we will substitute this in our expression. M squared plus 3m plus 8m plus 24. Take the common factor outside, it's m. M plus 3. Here common factor is plus 8. M plus 3. Because it's 8 times 3, we can take 24. M into 3, 3m. That's all. Take the common bracket outside, m plus 3, and write the remaining numbers in one bracket, m plus. So like this we can factorize. Now we'll discuss O. Here we should find factors of 28. 1 into 28, 2 into 14, 3 into 8, 4 into 7. And the most suitable one is to make positive 3 is we can take seven and 4. When we subtract 4 from 7, we receive the answer as 3. We'll substitute it in our expression. A squared plus 7a minus 4a minus 28. Like this we can. Then take the common factor outside, a plus 7. Here minus 4, because sign is minus, minus 4. A plus 7, and write the common bracket, A minus 4. This is the answer. Now Now let's discuss question Q. In the previous questions, we did the sums in the format m squared plus 6m minus 40, right? So we have to change the format of this into the standard format. That's m squared plus 6m minus 40. So we should find how to make positive 6 from 40. We can make 40 by four into ten, 40. So we should find how to make positive 6 by 4 and 10. When we subtract 4 from 10, we get the answer positive 6. So we should substitute this m squared minus 4m plus 10m minus 40. Take the common factor outside m minus 4. Here common factor is 10 m minus 4. Take the common bracket outside m minus 4. M minus 4 and m plus 10 is the answer. Now let's start second question B part A. Ten minus 3x minus x squared. So in the previous questions, x squared was plus, but in this x squared is minus. So it's better if we do this sum without changing the format. Then it becomes easy to do this sum. So 10. What are the factors of 10? 1 into 10 and 2 into 5. 2 into 5 is the most suitable pair of factors to make minus 3. How can we make minus 3 from 2 and 5? Then 5 should be minus, 2 should be plus. Then we can get the answer as minus 3, because minus 5 plus 2, the signs are different, so we should subtract 5 minus 2 is 3, and the sign of the largest number we should put to the answer. Sign of the largest number is minus, so we should put minus as the answer. And now let's make our next, rearrange the expression. 10 plus 2x minus 5x plus 2x minus 5x and minus x squared. Common factor is positive 2, 5 plus x, and here common factor is minus x, 5 plus x, because positive into negative, negative, x into x, x squared. Take the common bracket outside, f plus x, and the remaining we should write it 2 minus x. So this is the answer for 10 minus 3x minus x squared expression. 5 plus 6, 2 minus 6. Now let's do D. 50 plus 5x minus x squared. Here also it's minus, so it's better if we are not changing the format. So to make 50, what are the factors we should take from 5? We should make 5 we can make 5 by taking, so for factors of 50. We can take 10 times 5, right? Then we can make 5. So, how to make positive 5 from 10 and 5? When we subtract 5 from 10, we can get the answer as 5. 50 plus 10x minus 5x minus x squared. Common factor is 10. 5 plus x. Here common factor is x, and since it's minus, we should make this also minus. 5 plus x. Take the common bracket outside. 5 plus x and 10 minus x is the answer. Now let's discuss C part C. P squared minus 7p cube plus 12q squared. So here it's 12q squared. Okay. Now here there are two square numbers, and we should find how can we make 7 from this 12. So factors of 12, 1 into 2, 2 into 6, 3 into 4. So to make 7 more suitable pair is 3 and 4. We can substitute it as p squared plus 3p. Here sign is minus 7. So here also it should come minus 7, and the signs should be minus 4 and minus 3. Then only we can get the answer as minus 7. So p squared minus 3p cube minus 4p cube plus 12q squared. Here the common factor is p. P minus 3q. And here common factor is minus 4. And q is also common to both terms. So minus 4q. P minus 3q. Then we can get the answer minus positive into negative, negative into negative positive. 4 times 3, 12, q into q, q square. Take the common bracket. P minus 3q, p minus 4q. That's the answer. Now let's discuss exercise 7.2. First question, A part A. 2x squared plus 3x plus 1. So here in the previous questions we didn't have a number in front of x squared. We had like this x squared plus 3x plus 1, x squared plus 5x plus 10, like this. But here there's a number in front of x, so we should multiply the number in front of x and this 2 into 1, 2. So we should find factors of 2. It's already 2 into 1. So how to make 3 from 2 and 1? Both should be plus. Then we can make plus 3. Substitute it, 2x squared plus 2x plus 1x plus 1. Here common factor is 2x, x plus 1, right? 2x is 2x, 2x squared, 2x plus 1, 2x. Here common factor is plus 1, x plus 1, x plus 1, 2x plus 1. That's the answer. Now let's discuss question B. So here the number in front of a squared is 24. So we should here 1 is there. So we should multiply 1 by 24 and the answer is 24. Let's find the factors of 24. 1 into 24, 2 into 12, 3 into 8, 4 into 6. So the most suitable factor to make positive 10 is this one, 4 into 6, 4 and 6, both should be plus, and substitute this to the equation, y squared plus 4ay plus 6ay plus 24a squared. Here the common factor is y plus 4a. Here common factor 6 and a, because 6 and a is common. 6a, y, 6 times 4 is 24a. Take the common bracket outside, y plus 4a, y plus 6c. So this is the answer. Now let's discuss f. Two x squared minus 11x plus 15y squared. So here also there is a number in front of x square. So we should multiply 2 and 15. 2 into 15 is 30. We should find the factors of 30. 1 into 30, 2 into 15, 3 into 10, 5 into 6. So what's the most suitable pair of factors to make 11? Yeah, correct. It's 5 into 6. Here 11 is minus. When we are taking the number, we should take with the sign. Otherwise, our answer will be wrong. So the signs also should be minus. Substitute this to this equation, to this expression. 2x squared minus 5xy, because here xy is also there. xy minus 6xy plus 15y squared. Take the common factor outside. common factor is x. 2x minus 5y. Here the common factor is 3. 3 is common to both 6 and 15 and 1. Here the sign is minus, so we should take it as minus 3. 2y minus 3y. Minus 5y. Take the common bracket outside. So this is the answer. Now we are going to discuss 7.4 topic, and that's factors of the difference of two squares described further. In that, I will do the exercise and explain the sums. Let's discuss exercise 7.4. A. X plus 1 squared minus 4. So, in order to factorize this, we should make both the two terms as a power of a number. Then it's easy. Here x plus 1 is already a square, and we can make 4 by 2 into 2. 2 squared. Then we can write the expression, we can write the factorizing as x plus 1 minus 2 and x plus 1 plus 2. It's easy, right? But you should remember one thing. Here we should keep the answer in the simplest form, so we can do this sum further. We can remove the brackets. X plus 1 minus 2. X plus 1 plus 2. When we remove the brackets, then we can get the answer as plus 1 minus 2 minus 1 plus 1 plus 2 x plus 3. So this is the final answer of this question. Now let's discuss question number H. 16 minus m plus 2 squared. We can make 16 by 14 squared minus m plus 2 squared. 4 squared. 4 into 4 16. So m plus 2 it's already a square. So we can write the answer as 4 minus m plus 2 and 4 plus m plus 2. In the second factor, we should change the sign of this, and when we remove the brackets, we can find it for the sign is minus, so all the symbols inside the brackets change. Positive into negative, minus. Positive into negative, negative. M again minus 2, and here it's plus, so we can write the answer as it is because it's positive. Plus M plus 2, and the answer is 4 minus 2. Answer is 2 minus m. 4 plus 2 6 plus m. This is the answer. Now I am going to discuss the last sum of this lesson. Question J. 2x plus 3 squared minus x minus 2 squared. So in that already both the terms are in the squared format, so we can write the answer as 2x plus 3 minus x minus 2. And next one, 2x plus 3, I told you that we should change the sign, so minus becomes plus x minus 2. We should keep the answer in the simplest form, so we should simplify this further. So for that we have to remove the brackets. 2x plus 3, here the sign is minus, minus x, minus into minus, plus, plus 2. And here 2x plus 3 plus 6 plus 6 minus 2, because positive into negative, negative. Then we can simplify the answers, 2x minus 6, 6 plus 3 plus 2 plus 5. And here 2x plus 6, 3x plus 3 minus 2 plus 1. This is the final answer. Friends, now this is the end of our lesson. We have completed the 7th lesson. And if you think my teaching is good and if you understood the lesson, please don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel, share it, comment it and like it. And it's NS School Education YouTube channel. So stay safe in your homes and keep in touch with our YouTube channel. Thank you all for watching my video. Let's meet with another video.